Hello student, in previous sessions we have solved up to questions number 10. Now we will start from question numbers 11 onwards. So question number 11 is actually saying that, so we have to draw a flowchart and to print the multiplication table of n numbers. Like it can be a 10th table, it can be a 12th table, it can be a 14th, 16th table. So like that it will be like 1 into 1 into 1. Suppose if it is x, so x into 1, x into 2, x into 3, x into 4. So in this way, in this type of format, we have to make our table ready. Okay, so first of all, this x value, that is which numbered tables we want to make. It is a 16 table, it is a 17 table, it is a 19 or 20, which is actually the table that we need to find out first. So we have taken the inputs number, that is here I am showing it as x, but here I have declared the variable num to store the number. Now we can see that this particular number, when we are talking about a table, then the number need to be multiplied by 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then, so same job, the multiplication job we are repeating, but the multiplication value is keep on changing. So whenever we are repeating one step the multiple number of time, then there is a concept of loops comes. I have already explained to you. So that's why to continue the loop, we required a loop variable. Okay, so that's why we have declared a loop variable by I, and we are assigning it to 1, because if you are storing any multiplication value, then what will happen, you must initialize this variable to 1, but you cannot start a table with the particular number multiplied by 0, which always give you a 0 value. So we always start the multiplying table with the number multiplying by 1, so that's why the I value is initialized to 1. Okay, understood. Then we have a checking condition is, because see, the particular number can be multiplied by numerous number of, generally if you are building up a table, so that particular number is multiplied up to 10, like 1 into 1 2 into 1 2 into 3 1 into 3 1 into 4 1 into 5 1 into 6 1 into 7 1 into 8 1 into 9 1 into 10. So in this way, up to 10th we are generally preparing the table, rest of the part we are not generally considering. So that's why here they are checking that I value greater than 10 or not. So up to 10, we will doing the multiplication, we will consider the loop, and then we will complete. Okay, so I will keep on doing the multiplication thing. I am keep on doing the multiplication till the time our the condition has been satisfied. Till our condition has been satisfied, in this way we have to propagate it. Okay, so suppose I value is 1, if I value is actually less than, if it is greater than, then what will happen, if it is greater than, then what will happen, that I value, whatever is coming, it is greater than 10, that we can stop. If it is false, okay, false, okay, then what will happen, we have to go and keep on doing the multiplication job. Okay, so like I am checking, is I value is less than 10 or not. If it is less than 10, we will continue. So what we will continue, we will do multiplication. We have a num variable. Num variable need to multiply it by I, then we are storing into some prod or product, any value of it. So first of all, checking initially I value is 1. So initially when I value is 1, now you check I is less than 10, when 1 is less than 10, yes, 1 is less than 10, then do you do what? Okay, you do the multiplication num into I, that is whatever variable, suppose 16 into 1, then you are storing it over. Now I value is incremented, check in this way, I equals to I plus 1, I equals to I plus 1, which means what will happen, now I value initially 1 plus 1, 2, now 2 is less than 10, yes, 2 is less than 10. Here we are showing a greatest one checking, you can do for the less than checking also. So 2 is less than 10, yes, 2 is less than, or here equals to, we need to keep it. Yes, then again we will do what, 16 into 2. Okay, again I value will be incremented, so I value will be decreased to 2 plus 1, that is 3. 3 is less than or equal to 10. 3 is less than 10. Again, the number is multiplied by 3 and stored into the product variable. Okay, now I value again will be incremented. Okay, I value will be again incremented, and this becomes 3 plus 1, that is 4. So num into 4, whatever value we are having, we are storing into product. Okay, done. Now, in this way, while we are doing the propagations, so at the point of time, I value, actually after 9, that is 9 plus 1, 10, when the I value become 10, it will come for the checking over here. That is, I is less than 10. No, I is less than not 10. So that point on 10 value will be not printed. So that's why I have incorporated the equals to variable. Why I have incorporated equals to? If it is, I have not included the equals to variable, then it will be printed into num into up to 9. 10 it will not print. So when it is coming become 10, then it will check 10 is less than, no, 10 is not less than 10, but 10 is equals to 10. So that point of time, what will happen when 10 equals to 10, the number is itself multiplied by 10 and the loop will be terminated. Why the loop will be terminated? In the next time after doing the multiplication, I value will be increased, 10 plus 1. So 10 plus 1 means what? It will be 11. Now it is coming, I value, that is 11. 11 is less than or equals to 10. It 11 value is neither less than 10 nor the equals to 10. So what will happen, that it is saying that total condition is false. Till the condition satisfied, we are doing this multiplication. As our conditions become false, it means we will not gonna proceed our loop. We must stop our loop. So what will happen after that time, that we have to go for the printing. We have to go for the printing job purpose and we have to print the whatever value that each time we are doing the printing, that's this into this in this way. So next time the loop will not propagate as we have done, as the conditions become false. So check here in the question itself, the loop I am showing it over, it is showing it with a greater than value, but I am, whatever work I am doing over here, it is showing with the less than value. So whatever you feel like, you can go for it. Okay, the both the way of writing of a flowchart with the two different conditions I have shown you over here in the question paper itself. I have some another different type of conditional flowchart, and here I am showing in the board work, live board work, and some different kind of calculation. So whichever you feel like that you are actually okay with it, you can go for it. But thus there is a change in this, only in this conditional part, because there is a change, because if one is less than it is not happening, that is one is greater than zero. If it is true, one value cannot be greater than zero. If it is true, directly it is saying that you stop the loop. Directly it is saying it stopped the loop. And if it is an I value is greater than 10, and then what will directly, so when I value greater than 10 means when it is becomes 11, that automatically it will come to an hold. And if it is not, means condition is no, means condition is false, what we will do? We have to multiply it. We have to multiply I, that is I equals to num and store into the product variable. I into num and store it into the product variable. Okay. So in this way we have to do it. So this is the way, whatever condition you feel like in the diamond box, you can give it. I hope this flowchart is clear to you. Thank you, student, and ending my lecture over here.